Hey, what's going on, everybody? Chad Christian coming at you with another exciting video. Today I'm bringing you the HP Spectre x360. I've had it for a couple days and just wanted to give you a nice review on it, so let's get into it. On the left hand side here, we've got your USB 3.0, which is backward compatible. We got a 3.5 millimeter headphone jack, our ventilation system here, and our power standby button. And over on the right hand side here, we've got two USB-Cs, which are Thunderbolt 3s, and a volume rocker. And on the bottom of this unit, you just got your ventilation system here and two bottom facing firing speakers. And up on the top, you do have a speaker system here. There's two more speakers, so there's basically a quad setup. And the software setup for Bang and Olufsen. They sound really good, nice and full. Good speakers for a laptop. Let's go over the display real quick. I love the fact that they have these nice thin bezels. I love those. The brightness isn't the brightest panel that I've seen, but it does get bright enough. If you need a really bright panel, I probably would not recommend this for outside use, but inside it's perfectly fine, even under bright lights. You can see that the color saturation is really good, stays on par even at different angles. You know, sometimes you get redding like on the Dell XPS units, but this doesn't do that. The panel is a little bit on the yellow side. You can see on your whites there. If you compare this next to the whites that are on the MacBook Pro, you'll see what I'm talking about. Now the new MacBook Pro here, this has up to 500 nits of brightness, so that gets extremely bright. It's actually blinding me right now. I need to turn it down a little bit. But you can see the difference between the white and the yellowish contrast, just like with some of your phones, you can see the same thing. Now as far as the camera goes, this is a HD camera, but it's on par with, you know, some of the weaker cameras. It's about the same as the MacBook Pro. It's not great. I wouldn't use it for streaming games, but for Skype calls, things like that, it's not a problem. I just want to do a quick test of the speaker system here for you so you get an idea of how full and how it sounds. 50% volume.
We're going to do a quick unboxing. So let's get into it with my handy dandy.
And that's the unboxing video of the MacBook Pro. I'll leave a link down below here for you. So you can see the speakers sound really good. Good quality. They did a nice job with those. I listen to a lot of music and play games, so I love having a good sound system. So to me, that's a big plus. Now the trackpad. This is a glass-covered trackpad. I really do like the glass. I really do like the trackpad. You can see that all the gestures work fine. Everything works good with it. The only thing that I've noticed that's weird is it's got a little bit of a noise up on the very front of it. Let me see if you can pick this up. And it's only on the left side. Now, I don't know if that's my unit or all of them, but listen to that. That's without clicking the pad. See how you don't hear it on the right side? So, I'm not sure what that is. Sounds like a manufacturing problem. You guys will have to let me know in the comments below if you're having issues with yours. But, I mean, it's registering the clicks fine, so I don't see it being a problem. Now, this display does not support the Wacom or Digitizer stylus, but you can use any capacitive stylus with it. It's a bummer. You know, they're doing all the commercials and everything for styluses. I really wish they would have kept that support in there. I do like that feature. So there is no palm rejection, nothing special like that. So if you guys are looking for content creation as far as drawing and things, this is not the laptop for you. Now the keyboard. The keyboard's really a surprise for me. I actually really like the keyboard. It's really got a nice feel to it. Nice good bounce. You know when you've clicked on it, so I like that. No real flex in that keyboard with the, you know, the all aluminum build, so I like that. But again, my biggest pet peeve is the lighting on the keyboard. As you can see with the lights on in here, and I turn the lights on with my keyboard, hard to pick up on camera, but it can make it really hard to see the keys with just the right lighting if you turn those lights on or off depending on what you're doing with it. Because even though the keys are silver and it looks like gray for the lettering, when you turn those on, it's a white light that shines through it, and it makes it pretty hard to see sometimes. So I wish they would stop doing that. I know they want to keep this all beautiful, you know, silver design, but I would love it if they would put black keys on here with individual LED lights. Now the battery life on this is probably one of the best that I've used all year. The battery is king on this system. I haven't got to test the MacBook Pro. I just got it yesterday for longevity of the battery, but this thing is ridiculous. The draw is really minimal. It's not showing the draw right now. I use an app called Battery Bar. Works out really good, but it'll tell me my discharge rate. Given the fact that it's a touchscreen panel and it's bright, usually it's around minus 15 on the draw. So they did a really good job. And I don't know if that's just the Kaby Lake processor or what, but it's really good as far as battery goes. I can get about 11 to 12 hours with no problem on this, and that's streaming YouTube, you know, online, Netflix for hours and hours on end, listening to music. I mean, a lot of streaming and web surfing and social media. So battery's excellent. The design, like I said before, the fact that it's all aluminum and it's only 2.8 pounds with a Core i7, 8 or 16 gigs of RAM, up to 512 gig drive. This thing's a beast. My crystal disk scores were 1600 on the read and 300 on the write, which is fantastic. I'm going to show you guys some gaming right now just to show you what a little beast this thing is. Even though it's only an Intel HD 620 processor, this does not have a dedicated processor unit on it. I'm going to show you how it runs with Counter-Strike Go, then Borderlands 2 and Grand Theft Auto 5, which you're not going to believe how well that runs. So this is at medium settings. Let me show you real quick. 1080 medium, power saving mode is turned off. Shader detail, we don't want that on high. Okay, medium, all right. There we go. So you can see 56 frames a second. Runs very smooth. So anywhere from 46 to 53 frames a second, basically. 60, 66, 67. So yeah, it's running very well. No noticeable fan noise. Next up, we've got Borderlands 2. I'm running this at 1920 by 1080. And it looks like it's getting about 30 frames a second. I know it's really hard to see. It's super small up in that corner. Maybe once we get out of this white area. Very playable, no lag. Super fast, fluid. It actually looks like it runs it really well. Yeah, 27 frames a second, 32, So it's hovering around 30 frames a second. Now I can change the resolution and get faster FPS, so let's try that right now. And you can see that I've got it capped at 60. I think it recommended I run it at 1152 by 864. Now by running it at this resolution, so it's around, all right, 40, 42. There we go, we'll go into a controlled area so we can see. All right. 37, 35. Oh, it went to 1440 by 900, okay. There we go, at the recommended resolution. Right now it's getting 56, 53. So this is averaging around 45 to 50 on average. No fan noise, let me show you. Low, you can't hardly hear it at all. Good sound system on here. Yeah, see, it's 50 frames a second right now. Very playable. I think honestly I would just play it at full resolution and take a dip in frames. This isn't a twitchy action game where I have to get maximum frames per second. So you can see cutscenes are around 18 to 24, but let's see how this plays. What is that, 1020? Or I'm sorry, 1980 by 10, or 1920 by 1080. Might be a little low. It's dipping, all right, 25. Might get a little bugged up if you had a lot going on the screen at once, so you might have to turn it down a little bit, but you can see here in a pinch you could easily play this game. So let's try a newer title. So to really push this thing, I put Grand Theft Auto 5 on it. These are all my settings. Running 1440 by 900 full screen. Basically everything is off. VSync is off. Fuck up! Come on! In the back! Come on! Come on! In the back! Come on! Let's go! Come on! So this is what it looks like. Get in here and deal with the guard. 30 frames a second. Can't even believe this game's running on here. This is the Intel HD 620 is able to run Grand Theft Auto 5. With decent frame rates. Don't blow yourself up. Pay attention. Em, get these assholes in the closet. Let's go. Come on. What's he doing? Hey, what's all this in here? Leave us alone. We didn't do shit to you. This runs at great frame rate. A little bit of screen tearing, but my gosh, for a system this small, this is ridiculous that I can even play Grand Theft Auto 5 on here. So for anybody who wants to take this to school and do some gaming, yeah, this will work. I was going to put Battlefield 1 on here, but if it'll run Grand Theft Auto 5, I know it'll run Battlefield 1 on it. This is crazy. Look at that. bye.
Show me the money! What? Who wants some? Major score! Get that cash!
There's enough here for us all to enjoy. Depends on how you look at it. We're done here! Let's go!
21, 22 frames a second. 25.
I saw your face, I'll remember you. You get 1,000 things every day. How about you make sure this is one of them?
Yeah, for my overall verdict of this unit, I think it scores a definite touchdown. With the long battery life, excellent display, the fact that it's a convertible and you can use it in different modes for tight quarters, on your lap, presentation mode for viewing videos. Tent mode if you're using it in the kitchen, so you don't have to worry about splashes or anything, you know, nasty getting on the keyboard with it being flipped around face down. This is a definite buy. You can get this now at Best Buy. I'll leave a link down below. Incredible device. In the next video that you see with this, I'll do a head-to-head comparison between this and the MacBook Pro. So stay tuned for that. That's going to be an exciting video. And for those of you that are worried about the port issues, I was able to find this, the Satechi USB-C, which has three USB 3.0s, a full SD card reader, and a micro SD card reader. I'll leave a link for that down below. This thing works great to expand the storage and the port capacity on your system. Very easy, just clicks in. And you can put it any way you want. This way, you can put it in this way. I just prefer to put it in this way. Just like that. And as you heard, it's activating all the different ports. Works great. You can also put it in this way. Fantastic. It's $39.99 on Amazon. Like I said, I'll leave a link below. Highly recommend it for any of your MacBook Pros, any device that uses USB-C. I think you guys will like that. So that's going to do it today for my HP Spectre X360 review and gaming video. If you would hit that thumbs up, go ahead and subscribe for more videos like this. And I'll see you guys on the next one.